Hey, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Hash. How are you doing this fine morning? That didn't make a whole lot of sense. Although it's morning here, so it does make sense for me, I suppose. So get your coffee and, ooh. That one is all extracted quite a bit. Oh. I made pour over and I didn't reset my mill is set up for a mocha pot, so it's too fine. Darn it, now I'm gonna drink horrible coffee. But you're not here for that. You're not here for coffee, you're here for Minecraft. So I've been slabbing this morning. Quite a bit more. These guys are gonna be annoying. Can I get like a spot where these don't matter? I guess we just kill them. And go over here. So I've been slabbing this. Did sort of a circle because mobs despawn in a 100 outside of a 128 block sphere around the player. And because it's less work, right? If we did like a square 128 blocks, it would be like this whole corner need to be slapped too. But yeah, it's a sphere. And I still did too much work, I'm pretty sure. So how do you figure out how to do this sphere? Well, I did it by hand. You can basically check it. There's odd spots here now. Like basically there, for example, I checked and then I corrected. And I checked like every 10 blocks or so and then did the rest by feeling, right? You know how a circle looks, so you can roughly do a circle. And then a few extra blocks for safety. Getting lost. So if you want to figure out if a point is inside a sphere, like this point, for example, you can just do Pythagoras in 3D. So you take your AFK spot, that's the center of your sphere, right, where you are. And you take these coordinates and you enter the first one, 850. And from that you subtract the center points. And you power off 2. And then you do the next, right? It's like 80 minus 44 to the power of 2 plus 694. I'm not sure why I'm entering this because I'm not going to calculate this for you. To the power of 2. And you get a number out of that, like a pretty large number. And if that number is bigger than, say, 16,384 it should be, if this is bigger than the square of 128, then the point is outside of the sphere. If it's smaller, it's inside. If it's equal, it's right on the edge, so you should probably slap it. I'm not entirely sure how Minecraft handles this. But yeah, instead of taking these coordinates, which is our AFK spot, I added like 3 to these. So I did 69. Right? I added 3 to the X only. So we can move around a little bit there and have a few blocks for safety, because I knew I wouldn't check every single block. So you don't need a program for this, you can do this by hand. But I have a question for you, because I installed a mod today and that does this. I saw this in a video and I googled, hey, what's this mod that displays Shulker Box contents? And that's Mini Hut, which also gives you this Mini Hut over here. Which is quite useful, because then I don't need to have this open like 90% of the episode. It's kind of annoying. It's not get seen by that guess. Anyways, I couldn't help but notice shapes. Despawn sphere. Add shape. Configure. I can't remove this, that's annoying. 972 was it, right? And 44.5 and 651.5 972 44 651. Yes, okay. Enabled, and then you don't see anything. I guess we got a sphere. Oh, the hut probably. Oh, whoa. Stop it. The hut probably needs to be open. So, darn it. Like the Schalke Box preview I also had to enable, so I assume it's in here. It's not. So it didn't render hotkeys? Do we need a hotkey for? Oh. Shape renderer, 6. So, okay. So you see, we could have gotten away with doing less. And the question I have for you is, do you consider this cheating already? Because I'm actually not sure. Like, I think this is incredibly useful because it's a quality of life feature. And as I just told you and shown you, you can do this by hand, like no problem, right, with a calculator. But this is a little bit less work. So it's not really adding anything that you couldn't just do anyways with a little bit more time investment. It doesn't change anything. But I'm not sure. It's like, for some reason, I think this is like on the edge of cheating. Or maybe not cheating. Like, this is just a better calculator, right? So it's like a doped calculator, a calculator on crack. So the question I need to ask you is, doping cheating? Or is it okay? Wow, chicka, wow, wow. So you might wonder, why are we doing this? Because last time we were here, we established that I'm never gonna build that many beacons. And how many Wither Skeleton Skulls do you really need? Do you need 21? Plus, hey, that was my phone. Plus 41? Do you need 62 Wither Skeleton Skulls? You don't. I don't. But we are not doing this for the skulls. We are doing this for the gold. It's a nice little extra, actually. We are not doing this for the gold. For the bones? Not really, but this is a really nice extra. We're doing it for this stuff. And this stuff. For furnace fuel. Gonna need that for a future project. A lot of this. And this is like faster than a triple blaze spawner, I think, at this point already. And we can make it even faster. So this is the theme of today's episode, and Project Perfection. We want to make this as good as we can without slabbing the whole Soul Sand Valley. Which is where these guys come in. I bred these because I saw a video in my recommendations that these guys apparently can prevent spawning. And because of the way spawning works in Soul Sand Valleys, I also looked that up. You have like a skeleton, right? And it doesn't like reduce like a timer or a charge thing or something. I don't know why Mojang calls it a charge system. I also called it a charge system last time we were here. I mean, actually, this skeleton has like a sphere around it, and nothing can spawn inside that sphere. Or actually, stuff can spawn inside that sphere. But no Soul Sand Valley mobs, which are striders, skeletons, and ghasts. So what happens when we get a second skeleton? The spheres combine into an even bigger sphere. And this goes up to infinity, maybe. I don't know how far it goes. But in that video, Nemon said you can make the nether spawn proof with 15 of these guys. But I have like 19 here. Yeah, 19 seems to be. And my nether isn't spawn proof. Not quite. Oh, my Soul Sand Valley isn't spawn proof. Like, over here, the guys still can spawn. Now that I want to show this, there's gonna be no guys here. Oh, there's guys here. Plenty guys. These still spawn, as you see. This is how it spawns. You can see. So there is a sphere, but it's not big enough. It's not 140 blocks diameter. It's more like, I don't know, 80 at this point or something. And, like, every strider you add only adds like a tiny bit at this point. So we probably need like 50 of these to make the spawn proof, and then what's the point? Because at that point, these take away from the mob cap, even though they are passive animals. At that point, we barely get any spawns up there because these are taking up the cap. So we're gonna put them down. However, there's one more thing we could do that's quite a bit easier than slabbing the whole Soul Sand Valley, which will be insane. So these guys, I got a million of these. So we just go here and place them in like a line, every couple of blocks. Doesn't matter, doesn't need to be super accurate, because these create a lot of lights. Or a lot of light, not lights. when skeletons in the Nether still need light to spawn. And if we make sure we never have more than 4 spaces between them, yeah, more than 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, guests would also not be able to spawn. So just go along this. Can make quite the big area with this pretty fast and prevent guest spawns and skeleton spawns, and that's about that. So there's one more thing we need to do here to make this really cool. Actually, two more things. I want to put pistons in here so they push the mobs together periodically, probably based on this clock. Possibly optional, so they don't cause mob cramming when we are really AFK and not like periodically clicking. And that way we only have to click in the middle, right? Mobs are getting pushed together. Like the blazes like to hang out in the side here. So that's one thing, that's a really simple thing though. The more complicated thing is, we get a lot of swords from this. And I don't just want to throw these away. I want to melt them down. And the problem is, the stone variant, it doesn't melt. Only the gold one does. So what we need here is a sword sorter. Now you cannot do this with redstone, but look at this, you can do this by hand. But what if we didn't have to do this by hand? That's where this guy comes in. I called him Guy. And he's our sword sorter. Or he's gonna be our sword sorter once I have this figured out. But I have it partially figured out already, and there's a soul torch here. And these guys don't like soul torch. They're scared of soul torch. That's why he doesn't walk in this direction right now. That's why he stays put in that one spot. And if we give him a stone sword... Darn it, I don't have a button. If we give him a stone sword... He's still not gonna walk around. And the soul torch isn't so bad... when he gets his favorite thing, which is a gold sword. So we can get a redstone output from that. So, the plan. We also gotta make sure this guy never tracks me. Once he tracks you, it's it's not over, but he takes a while to lose the tracking of you. But the easy way to prevent that is by having him enclosed, so he can't pass to you. But yeah. What we can do is just put a hopper here. And we will lock that hopper. And that is really simple, because we just put a piece of redstone here. And now the hopper is locked. And if we throw a stone sword at the hopper... Dun, dun, dun. Nothing happens. And then we somehow get rid of the stone sword. And if we throw a golden sword on the hopper... This guy steps on the pressure plate. And unlocks this before he can pick it up. I mean, he can't pick it up anyways because he pushes himself back with the piston. He's not very smart, this guy. But he's very good at sorting swords. Eventually. Once I got this figured out. So, basically what we need to do is we need to put a hopper on this. And, I mean, we can, like, start to build this up while I talk. I don't want to do this on camera, really, because I haven't figured it out yet. It's gonna take a while. But I want a comparator, I want droppers. Dropper. And I think that's it for what I want right now. Let's maybe get some repeaters too, just in case. Okay, so what we can do... Oh, what my plan is. Is to get a comparator output from this. Then we know there's a sword in there. And we wrap this around. We probably want to put this a little bit further away, actually. Now that I see this. First of all, this is gonna go into a ledge, an ice ledge. So we shoot an item from here into here. And then we have an item in here. And this... We will take... And put it into this block. And put it into a piece of redstone here. And that's gonna do two things. First of all, it's gonna shoot out this sword. Second of all... it's gonna lock the hopper that's on top. Right? Because it paused this block directly and there's a hopper on top. So no new swords enter here. And we will handle this down there. Wait until this guy reacts, or wait a couple of seconds. If he doesn't react for a couple of seconds, we will push the sword out of the way into lava or something. Because then it's the stone sword. And once we do that, we will reset this and trigger this shooter over here. But first, I'm gonna move all of this one block. And I will probably be back with you with a finished thing. I need a new guy. Come on. Uh-oh. No. No! Might work. I only tried it a couple times so far, but let's try it together. We get this, which has a random distribution of sorts that we might get from this farm, and put it into here, or whatever. And then see what's happening. Turns out a gold sword. He goes for it, and it's in the right barrel. Stone sword doesn't go for it. Still doesn't go for it. Still doesn't go for it. And it's in the left barrel. Haha. So the way this works is really simple. We have this thing that locks the hopper above that I already showed, basically. And we also take a torch output from that over here. So this turns off once we shoot an item out. And that will make this circuit here decay in strength. So you see, it gets dimmer. And once it's at zero here, this torch turns on and resets the whole thing and extends this piston. Now, furthermore, when he steps on the pressure plate, the torch below this block turns on and extends this piston, so it also resets. So when there's a gold sword there, we don't have to wait until this fully decays. We can just pick it up, reset, shoot out a new one. We can save a little bit of time here. As you see, I got rid of the piston. Darn it, I didn't close my mail program. I got rid of the piston because actually it didn't do much, I found out. Because he will run back anyways because of the soul torch. Unless he's tracking me, in that case this kind of breaks. Although I haven't figured out yet when he starts tracking me sometimes. I think it's only when I'm down here. You can look through like some block corner or something. So let's see. Only gold. Only stone. And when testing, I got a gold sword in here. Apparently, sometimes he takes even longer to pick that up. We can fix that by making the circuit decay even slower. It's a really easy thing to do. Just add another comparator to that. We can also just not care about it, because we obviously want this to have some speed, because it needs to be able to keep up with this farm. And if you lose like 1 out of 100 swords, gold swords, that's not a problem. Much bigger of a problem is if a stone sword would end up in here. Because if that happens, the whole smelting stops, right? Because stone swords don't do much in a smelter thing. I guess, does it even go into a furnace? It might only be a problem once we have 5 stone swords. If we put one in here. Oh. Oh yeah, it does go into a furnace. So, one stone sword, already too much. So far I haven't seen that happen yet, and yeah, he only has one more sword to sort. So for now, I think this is gonna work. Okay, over here I trapped the mobs up there. This is gonna be scary, removing this and getting them down here. But I had to set up this piston push together thing. So we have a second lever here now. And those pushes and the pistons together. So this works independently, but if this is on, which shoots the mobs over the ice blocks up there, right? Set that up with a torch tower 2 episodes ago. If this is on and we turn this on, this also pulses, right? Because you don't want mobs to stay on top of the piston heads forever. So that's about that. That's super easy. We just have a torch here and might depower that from another torch, and we have that connected to the torch tower. It's like not too complicated. I need to cover up all this wiring, and then we'll see you when we remove this glass. I also added an item elevator here to get it into a furnace. It's a blast furnace, so it's fast. This is basically the same dropper design that I use in my storage room. So you might have seen that before, otherwise you gotta check out episode 15 or something. I'm not sure. But let's try it out. Stay back here so he doesn't check us. We also added like lava there, so stone swords actually die now. Hey! It's silent. I hope this can keep up with a whole bunch of stone swords. Gold swords. Otherwise we can just extend this, make this a little higher. And add a barrel. Actually, I should probably do that before wrapping this up. Anyways, these guys now. Let's maybe get some armor. And get this ready. Because we want to put this here. And ideally, we want all three glass blocks. Wait, wait. That's an easy way to do this. No! Darn it. That's what I feared. Okay. 3, 2, 1. No! It's the wrong hotkey! Alright, it's only 1.5! Nice! So this wasn't dangerous after all. Darn it. I just lost a whole bunch to cramming. Coffee now. So I want you to pay attention to the entity card. Wait. I set this up perfectly for my needs. I'm gonna pay attention to the entity count. It's 83 right now. If we kill these fools, it's gonna drop quite substantially. It's also will increase. It's gonna increase a little bit because of the items, but once those are picked up, we are consistently below 60 even. The mob cap is 70. So this farm isn't really limited by the other mobs in this area anymore. Even though I only lit up a tiny portion, like maybe a fifth of the source and valley. But instead we are probably limited by the spawning spaces we have here. But technically you can fit 3 layers into an intersection. We might even struggle fitting a second layer in. Because we are using that piglin to get the mobs down here. At least the wither skeletons. But we're gonna try at some point. Maybe next episode or in another episode. And yeah, otherwise this has been mostly working like a charm. Sometimes the stone sword ends up in here because this guy still tracks me through the wall. Not sure how to prevent that. Apart from wearing gold armor, then it's totally fine. And it's not a big deal, right? Wearing like a gold chest piece. I stand here. And then that never happens. At least hasn't happened so far. But yeah, do we bring the gold? Yeah, sure, why not? And we'll bring these three. So this is set up in a way where we can put shulker boxes here, which is good. We'll also bring our redstone chest. And I think this one, yeah. And that hay bale's in here for target blocks. The rest of the stuff we are gonna leave here for now, I think. This we can take with us. Already working a little bit on the cleanup. Darn it! And because, so this is how much I've done. I've done this stuff and this stuff up here. And that's it. And because these Let's Plays sometimes seem a little segregated, I suppose. Or dislodged. Like, the world doesn't seem like it's one place, right? So maybe I should show you how I get to this place and back. Actually, I'm gonna show you back. Although I'm not sure. I just fly, and I don't know the way. Like, this is wrong. There's a dead end here. I've seen that dead end before. And let's see if we can get back. I think we fly through here. Why not? Woo! This is still a dead end? Maybe? Maybe not? It's a dangerous flight, by the way.
Wow!
Oh, there's a portal. Yeah, I've seen that portal before. And I've seen this bastion before. Ideally, we want up to end up at the snow base, which has the portal in this Soul Sand Valley, I believe. But finding that spontaneously is... I have no idea where I am. Oh, now I know where I am. The portal is over here. Okay. So we might want to build an ice road at some point. Even though, like, if we build, like, landmarks, like little rings or something, so we know which way to fly. I think flying is going to be faster than Blue Ice Road even. Not entirely sure on that. And yeah, we're going to this place. Still have a little bit of time in this episode. In which we will spend on some research. Because the next project we want to perfect a little bit for our future project. So we need a lot of furnace fuel and we are going to need decent amount of emeralds. And I have one villager here, which is perfect. He has a paper trade. The paper trade is actually not important. Not that important. But this trade is important. Bookshelves. Then you can make emeralds with books. Also important is glass, because I want glass. And ink sacs, because we have the ink sac farm over here, in case you don't remember. So ideally, you want to keep this guy. And I think I have two more of these perfect ones. Get rid of all the imperfect ones. Like this one doesn't have bookshelves. This one doesn't have books. Right? We want to be able to make a lot of money. And these seem to be the best because they are self-sufficient, right? You buy a bookshelf for one emerald, you get three emeralds out there. Out of that. And you can also trade a bunch of ink sacs and potentially paper. I'm not sure how low paper can go. But 13 is too much to be worth your time clicking. 8 is probably good. Ideally, it would be 4. But I'm not sure if it goes down to 4. So, the what do we need? We need a villager breeder, a better one. Than the one we had here a long time ago. Want to make a lot of villagers so we can kill a lot of villagers which don't have the perfect traits. And I already measured this out, so we are probably gonna build it somewhere around here. So when we hang out here and test the villagers, we have this far enough away so these guys spawn, but we are close enough so most of these guys don't stop moving. And then we get more ink sacs, which we are gonna need a lot of because we want to make a lot of money. And first, I want to find a fresh villager. Do I want to find a fresh villager? That doesn't actually matter, the fresh villager. We can use some of these, because we don't need those anymore. Or some of those. But eventually we won't use fresh villagers, because most of these guys probably have stuff in their inventory. And that's gonna be impossible to find out, really. I mean, it's probably possible, but it's much easier to like make a new villager from zombie. What we want is some iron. Oh, we do have some iron. Because I obviously want the villager breeder to be as small as possible. That's how you make chains, good. So the first thing we're gonna test right over... Let's put some of the stuff away. I already brought some stuff here before. First thing. I'm gonna try right over. Actually, let's go one block lower so we can bring them with the boat. Hey! I said hey to my phone because my phone said hey to me. I keep forgetting to mute it. Let's try it over here. Having these guys on chains, can they stand on that? You have two in here? Or do they fall through the side? They probably don't, right? We don't. But when they breed, do babies fall through the side? That's the important question. Maybe we'll get some glass to see. Do all of this in one take. Learn to not cut that much. Dun, dun, dun. And this, at least one block lower. Maybe two even. Because why not? Get some glass here. And build a staircase. And get a boat. I think there was a boat somewhere in here still from testing. Yes. So, you are bad, right? Dun, dun, dun. We'll do this and put a boat here and do this, and then you can walk out and get into the boat. I know you want to. Do I need to drive into you? Come on. Get in the boat. Get in the boat. Hey. Nope. We also need beds, right? So they can see that. See the beds. Because we don't have any beds over here. If I destroy this, are you gonna fall into there? Or are you gonna be annoying? You fall into that. Okay. Let me get the second guy really quick. Very good. Give them a bunch of beds that hopefully the other guys can't see. And I believe they need to be able to at least theoretically path through these beds. So we are gonna give them a bunch of trapdoors. Like here. And here. And I think they also want some sustenance to make a laugh. We'll give them a little bit. I'm not sure if that's enough. I think these guys are really hungry. Come on. Actually, there's another thing I want to try out. These guys can't jump out of that, right? Because it's 1.5 blocks high. They're standing on chains. Can they pick up food if I bring it here with a water stream? Yes, cool. That's good. I mean, these beds don't count because there's stuff on top of them. Or maybe the other villagers over there took the beds. Or maybe those guys see those villagers and don't want to make love because there's too many villagers. Maybe if we close this off. Hey, you guys want the lights on or off? You guys maybe want this open? Hey! Okay. Come on. It's not gonna fail, right? It's gonna work. Okay, there's a... we have baby. That baby doesn't fall down. Okay, can the baby not fall down? Or does it just path perfectly to not fall down? So I get in here and bump stuff. Oh, the baby is down. Okay. So this could work. I would like this to be faster though. Okay, I put a block there. Now you get over. No. Come on. Get over to this side. I know you want to. Come on. Yes, 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 yes. Okay. Now stay there. Give me that chain. And let's place this like this. Okay. Now we are doing the same for you. Come on. Come on. Come on. Wait a second. We can probably make this smaller, right? Like have both of them in 1x1 space. It's where's the boat? Damn it, it's despawned. Where are you going? No. Come back. What how did you get out? Darn it. Okay, but that's good. Because now we can do this. This doesn't connect to anything, right? Okay. And I do this. And put another trap door. I wonder if we can have people right next to each other. Like if we have a villager pair on here, can we just do, not this game. Can we just do this? This serves two purposes then. It blocks the water from flowing into here. At least on this block, but we can also do this. And we can possibly have another villager pair here, because I don't think they can see through this. For pairing, for breeding. It's a... We can just try, right? Like we get one of them in here and the other in there, see if they breed when we kill the baby. In there. Yes. Where is the other guy? Is he hiding in the sugar cane? He might be. Is he hiding in the ice? He's not hiding in the ice. Is he hiding on the beds? He's not hiding on the beds. Where are you? Did he get trapped in the villager trap? Nope. Everything's dead here. Yeah, I can't find this guy. I don't want to have a villager on the loose. So note to self, we need to kill one villager. You are not perfect. Hey, I got a job for you. It involves making love. So I'm sure you want that job. You're gonna fall in the right hole, right? Yes, good. Good job. We're gonna supply these guys with a bunch of chew again. That should be enough for this guy. And this guy too. Hey! I don't know the password, but will you let me in anyways? Yeah, I don't think anything is gonna happen between these two. So let's get another villager. Yoink! Yeah, you can get in there. Now I hope these share the food somehow. We'll just give them a bunch to make sure. Right? No one picked this up. Yes, good. Close this off. Get in here. And they're already making out. And the baby drops down. Cool. So we can do this. Have two of them in there. And then we have this ultra compact. And two in here, and two in here, and two in here. And make like 8 babies at a time or something. Crazy. And because they need eye contact. Get rid of this trapdoor for now. Just for testing. In the end. We need to place the trap boss before we do this. And I get this here. Get rid of this now. And see if these guys can make a new baby. We want to make sure these guys have plenty food. I know, maybe I'm very easy to excite, but harvesting this is still so fun to me. So fast. Look at who I found. Nobody saw that. Yeah, sure, I would like some of that blue stuff. And I guess while we wait, we can already set up a beacon, so we can insta-mine out that hole over there where we will put the villager breeder. It's interesting that you don't get the achievement for making a beacon in the Nether. Because I made a beacon before. At full power. Okay, let's see if these guys made a baby. Nope. I think it's safe to say that they cannot. Because they can't see each other with a glass inside that. But just to be sure, let me take this out. And see if they make one now. Yep, instant love. Alright. So anyways, that's gonna be it for today's episode. I will see you in the next one. Goodbye, take care. And make good coffee. Don't set your mill to the wrong setting.